Good morning, Cougars! Happy Super Stews Day! And welcome back to the Cougar Campus News. SamTrans is looking for a youth ambassador from San Mateo County. If you regularly use SamTrans public transit port, this is a chance to gain volunteer experience. If accepted, you'll be given a free monthly bus pass and $200 stipend at the end of the program. The applications can be found on the SamTrans website. Applications are open until September 14th. Hey Cougars, do you want to be a lawyer? Or do you just like to argue and want to practice your public speaking skills? Mock Trial is the club for you. Join us for a first meeting in Mr. Lurie's room, D4, after school today at 12:30 for a quick informational meeting. Come be a part of the team, get some experience in the courtroom, and have some fun! Local scholarship application is now open on Naviance for all seniors. Last day to submit application is November 9th. Hey Cougars, are you having trouble charging your Chromebook? Here's the librarian, Miss Smith, with some helpful charging tips.
Oh, you need to charge it.
Nope. Okay, good. Let me, okay. Is that a mouse?
No.
Okay. Let's look right there. That little icon is for a mouse. So, flip that puppy around. That little light tells you you're on the charging side. Make sure you're charging your HP Chromebook that way. And while we're at it, if you have an Acer, sometimes it will say you can't log in. Make sure that you just go to forgot email, and then you can push that. It will tell you that you can still log on, and then you're good to go that way. With this one, if you need to borrow a Chromebook, make sure you bring in your cell phone, and we are going to take your cell phone until you bring this back, that period, as collateral. Thank you.
Thanks, Ms. Smith. Now, Cougars, do you ever wish you could just relax a little at school? I sure do. Well, come to today's Tea Club gathering. We meet at lunch every Tuesday in room K13. Interact Club's first meeting is tomorrow at lunch in Ms. Trainer's room, G11, for returning members. Make sure to be there to talk about new important ideas. There will be a mandatory Environmental Club meeting this Thursday about community service opportunities and club projects. Snacks will be provided. Come to Mr. Centoni's room, K5, to save the planet. Tennis Club meets every Thursday on the tennis courts. Come by Mr. V's room for membership forms. See you Thursday at the courts at lunch. Good, super fabulous fun with Tennis Club. Now, here's Lauren with the sports.
Congratulations to the cross-country team for an outstanding effort in their opening meet of the season at the San Francisco Invitational held in Golden Gate Park. The freshman-sophomore girls team finished in third place out of 21 teams in their race. They were led by flying freshman Jada Bodas, who finished in eighth place overall. Anna Bickle was just behind in 12th place. So sophomore Lane Foss and Julia Mingstein finished in 31st and 33rd, and freshman Natalie Kerthroys rounded out the scoring in 51st place. Juniors Claire Yerby and Kendall Mansukani ran separately in the races. They each ran solo in their own race after Kendall fell at the start of the first race. Claire Yerby absolutely tore it up, finishing in sixth place with a time of 17:37. She ran smooth and smart and set the bar high for anyone in the PAL to match. Kendall ran the second heat and finished in fifth place with a time of 17:50. Her time was the second fastest PAL time. On the boys' side, freshmen Owen Wolliver, Matt Spink, Julio Rodriguez, and Jonathan Billington competed in the freshman boys' race. Kenny Jones and Harrison Nash ran well for the boys in the sophomore race. Competing for the first time ever for Half Moon Bay was exchange student Lucas Cruz. The varsity boys ran hard and were the third PAL team in their race. Members of that team were James McEachin, Arthur McKenzie, Thomas Harrell, Kohei Tanaka, Charlie Vale, and Carlos Martinez. This weekend, the team travels to SoCal to compete in the prestigious Woodbridge Invitational. Here are the Rocky players of the game, following the football team's big win Friday over San Mateo. Offense, Kellen Royce, who showed grit and leadership, paving the way for the Cougar rushing attack. Defense, Luis Antonio, who had four solo tackles and six assists, including two sacks, and just seemed to be around the ball all night. Special teams, Cade Duncan, whose blocked punt helped spur the momentum for the Cougars. scout Sean Nugent, whose hustle and team spirit helped the Cougars get ready for the game. The Cougars will face El Camino High School this Friday at home. JV starts at 4:30 and varsity will kick off at 7:30. Go Cougars! Interested in college athletics? Come to the biannual Student Athlete College Bound Workshop at HMBHS Library tomorrow at 6:30. Learn how to prepare for the recruitment process, applications, clearance, and playing college athletics. Parents are encouraged to come as well. Again, that is tomorrow at 6:30. And now here's Mr. Olson with the Daily Tribune.
Happy Tuesday out there, Half Moon Bay High School. The answer to yesterday's question was Roger Federer. Congratulations to Mr. Westwood and his class. They were the fastest answer. And thanks to Mr. V, who sent in the question. Now, today our category is U.S. Presidents. Watch your email for the question from me and have a terrific Super Tuesday, Half Moon Bay High School.